Of course, it would be unfair of me to kind of just show and go leave this topic of noise without looking at images with noise. Take my example of the zebra image here. If I was to compute the gradient of this zebra image, I would get something like this. Really well-defined ridges, as we have looked at before. Something that'll let me kind of figure out exactly the details I need. However, let's add some noise. Here you notice the graininess has shown up. And while there is still well-defined edges, and you can see them, let's see what happens when we do the gradient computation on it. And here I'm basically showing you the gradient magnitudes. More noise has started showing up here, and the lines here are not as well-defined. Even more noise has been added. It's really getting hard to connect these lines up anymore. And in fact, more of the image starting to have the kind of flavor that we saw in the 1D example previously. Even more noise has been added. Human perception is very good. You might still be able to see the ridges and stuff like that, but purely looking at the signal, you see absolutely no information here anymore. So as we go from no noise to a lot of noise, we basically the gradient magnitude here now seems to not be able to kind of showcase how we would actually be able to locate the gradient changes, the rapid or not rapid changes that where perhaps an edge might be. So any guesses what we would have to do to help us still compute gradients that would be used for doing things like edge calculations? Well, the simple answer is we should be doing smoothing to an image before applying any kind of gradient operations. So take this original image, and if you run it through some sort of a filter, remember all of the blur convolutions and Gaussian convolutions and stuff like that we've looked at. If we'd apply it before, we should be able to have remove some of the noise and then use that to compute our edges or gradients that could be used for other things, including computing edges.